you know, $10.
Yeah, exactly. And yeah, I think we'll it will go. Them. I think if you auction stuff.
Yeah.
So we'll let people know there'll be a memorabilia up for auction.
Yeah.
And you could, there's two ways to auction, Robert. You either put it on a table and people do bids, and then at the end of the night, you announce it, or you.
Or it's at the ring.
Or at the ring.
At that time.
People raise their hand.
Like Brandon, whoever wants, you know, $10, $5, you know, shit like that.
Yeah, no, I think so. And tell people to bring cash, because if they want to go home with souvenirs, and why not? There is for a great cause. And
it's for a great cause.
So that's great. And the parents are coming.
Yes.
Frank is just going to be there. He's not selling beer, so don't worry. The beer is not going to be watered down.
Fucking Frank, man. He's going to be... He's not going to do nothing.
We'll get somebody...
Not even going to volunteer.
We'll get somebody... You guys are going to be gone right
now. Okay.
Ellie, you're going to...
Frank don't even...
I'll stay a little bit, and then I'll bounce.
Frank
don't want to volunteer,
man.
He doesn't want to volunteer? No. Thank you. I'll give it back to you tomorrow. No, I will.
Let me give you some socks. Because they're not going to get sick.
No, I'm going to...
Thank you. What are you saying, Robert?
No, he's asking if I want something to eat. I said, I'm waiting until I get home. My wife.
No, I'm good. Thank you. Yeah. I got to ask you this. Look at this. Alexis Espino in the house. Just woke up.
I should have seen this right now, Alexis.
What happened?
Well, you guys.
Oh, he's going to see the video.
So, what's up, Alexis?
What's up, everybody?
What shoes are those? Are those Kanye West?
Yeah.
They're very expensive. They're like $600.
No.
$700?
No.
Pio, what are they?
If you resell them. That's if you buy them or retail and then resell them.
Yeah, but if you buy them when they come out, they're like $220.
Robert.
Too expensive, fool.
Yeah, but like, they're not crazy.
But not for Alexis Espino.
Fuck it.
Hey.
80 her money, right?
July 29?
Yep.
Where is it?
Rhode Island.
Rhode Island. Your third pro fight.
Yeah.
How do you think you're going to do?
I think I'm going to do.
Thank you. I appreciate it.
So
okay.
That way you're good.
I appreciate it. Thanks so much, Virgil.
Better, right? Yeah, he's doing better and better. Sparring 8 rounds you sparred yesterday with Falcao.
Yeah.
He's sparring good. He's
How old is he now? 20?
19.
Just a kid. You have a whole career ahead of you.
Gotta be
what smart. Advice do you have for him, Robert?
Do it right. Gotta be smart and do it right. Look, it's so easy to just, you know, he's been in camp ready for this is his third fight. He already sees.
Where are you going?
Hawaii bar, now.
Oh no.
No, sorry. Thank you, Pita.
Look, he's already been around fighters that are doing really good, world champions, world-class fighters. You know, he sees the way, right now, you know, Mikey, Jose Ramirez, Virgil Ortiz, the way they're training, the mentality they have, when the way they take care of themselves outside of the gym. And he's also been around, you know, the other ones that like to fuck around and drink and get drunk
have
and shit like that.
Have a good time and not be serious. So, not take their career seriously.
So, you know, what advice can I tell him is, he sees that he's got to know which direction is the best one to take, right? Which direction is the best one to take? So he already knows. You know, obviously in the gym, I do my work with managing and the training, and you know, I got Chepe, I got Virgil helps out, I got Pete, I got Pio. My dad comes and helps out too. So that's easy work, I could say.
But at the end of the day, it's up to the fighter, because you could tell him advice, Virgil. You could give him advice, Robert. But he's going to do what he does. So if you do the right thing, you'll do great. If you want to mess around, and we've seen a lot of talented fighters.
If every fight, you know, you get paid, and in 2 days, and you already run out of your money because you spend it on parties and drinking and women and music and everything, then you don't expect much from that fighter. You know what I mean? It's especially with those that are coming up, you know. Once you're a fighter making millions and you want to party for 2 weeks, a lot of them do it.
Yeah,
a lot of them do that.
Well, it's not easy taking punches to the face.
A lot of
them, they have to.
They party for 2 weeks. They get fucking faded. They fucking get high. But they got the money to do it. And, you know, I'm not saying it's good.
They can afford it.
But they do it.
Like Brody, look, people get mad at Brody.
Brody likes to party.
He went to the bank right now. He withdrew $110,000. He's going to a club tonight. Yeah,
exactly. So fuck it.
It's his money, right?
And he probably has $4 to $5 million in his bank.
$10 million.
Maybe, exactly. So good for him. Fuck it. Maybe shouldn't do it, because if he wants to live that lifestyle after he retires, I think it's not going to happen. Because you're going to see we've seen a lot of fighters that have made millions and millions, and they end up broke.
Unfortunately,
we've seen it with many, many fighters.
Athletes in general. I know NBA players that have 20, 30 million and ask me for $20 when they see me, and it's sad.
So that's
when you have 20 million.
It's true. It's true. So those are things that, you know, we could give them advice. We could give them examples. Look at this. Look at that. Look at so and so.
So let me ask you, Robert.
What do you want to be?
What should athletes not buy? Should they not buy jewelry? Should they not buy cars? If you had advice.
Look.
What?
Look. Mikey's buying cars.
Right.
Mikey's buying, you know, he's got two Lamborghinis.
Yeah.
Those motherfuckers are worth like $700,000 each.
Wow.
The ones that he's got.
Yeah.
Yeah,
Pa,
you know who Mario Zavala is?
Yeah, I know who's that. Yeah, por qué?
He's saying what's up, like he's alive right now. How many people you got?
232.
And, look, but he's also buying apartments, he's also buying properties, you know what I mean? So, he's also, you know, he grew up, you know, he likes that fucking speed, so why not, you know, he could buy his cars, but he's already...
But he has other sources, property.
He's already securing his properties, his family, his kids, their school for the future, you know what I mean? If you're doing that, okay, then go buy, you know, he's not spending, you know, $200,000 fucking partying and getting high, drinking, yeah. You know, doing drugs. He's not, you know, so why not, you know? I'm not saying this... You know,
no, but I'm saying some of these people buy like a $400,000 car.
When they made $500,000 in their fight. Okay, that's a problem.
Exactly.
And he has cancer.
Who? Oh, shit. Are you serious? That's what somebody said. Oh, man.
I mean, maybe rent one or like take it out of your system for a couple of days.
A lot of fighters, you know, they get they get their first $1 million payday.
Run.
And they go fucking buy a fucking Bentley for fucking $400,000.
You're right.
Then they have to pay fucking taxes. Then
insurance.
At the end of the year, they don't have money to pay their taxes, and they fucking have to turn the car in because they can't even afford the insurance.
Someone told me, is this true that an oil change for a car like that is like $25,000?
I don't have one of those cars.
But that's what they do. But I think about
it. Just my wife herself. You know, she's got a small Mercedes, and it's fucking expensive to do oil change on those kind of cars.
You're right.
It's not easy. You go, you know.
What about jewelry, Robert? Because jewelry has no price.
I don't like jewelry.
Yeah.
You never see me in jewelry. But,
except the wedding ring.
Well,
I know, I'm joking.
And my Isaac Colunga, Isaac Strong wristband.
But that's it.
We are, look.
There's some trainers that wear a lot of gold and diamonds.
Yes, you know. If you could afford it and if you like jewelry, why not? So what? But you could afford it. You got your home secured. You got your kids secured. You got your future, you know, properties, money in the bank. Then that's fine.
But I'm going to tell you the problem. I used to work for a jeweler many years ago, security. And the guy used to brag to me, you see this bracelet? It cost me $1,500. Watch how we sell it for $80.
Yeah.
There's no value. There's
right.
It's what people are willing to pay.
Yes.
So if you go and you buy jewelry, know that you should always, it's always open for like, hey.
I understand that.
Give me a better price. Fighters sometimes.
But if a fighter, you know, not making a lot of money yet, but say one day he makes $100,000 pay.
Yes.
Okay? And if he goes and buys $80,000 worth of jewelry, then that's fucking stupid.
And he shouldn't do it because the jewelry, listen, if you buy jewelry, there's some superstars they used to go in and buy. Go to downtown LA. Go to the guys that sell it to the stores. Same stuff. But know that my dad was once in the gym and someone wanted to sell him a chain for $26,000. I took it to a store and they told me the value was $12,000. He still paid $26,000. But I'm saying, like, if you have the money to spend...
Yeah, they hustle them?
It's okay. It happens. It's boxing. But I'm saying...
No, it's not okay. It's not boxing. So they hustle them.
But he should have been smarter, right? It's up to the fighter. You know, he doesn't have to spend money. It happens. So
I wouldn't buy a chain from a guy just selling it to me.
But if a guy that bought it, you know, buys an $80,000 chain, but made $10 million in his last fight...
Exactly.
Why not?
Who cares?
Fuck it.
Yeah.
He already bought... $2 million worth of properties.
You're right.
Then you're good.
Yeah.
You're good.
That's true.
You know, you bought beat up homes and flipping them, you know.
So what would you recommend fighters? If you made your first payday, be like a person who won the lotto, try not to spend it for 6 months, be smart, well, don't go crazy.
You know, depends on what the purse is. You know, if it's going to be $100,000, $100,000, you know, a young kid, I wouldn't want them to buy jewelry or spend it all in the car. But let's be real. If you win and you know after that fight you're probably gonna go to the $1 million paydays, and if you bought, you know, you got $100,000 and you want to buy yourself a nice fucking Escalade or something, because you already, $100,000 is not gonna buy you a property either.
Correct.
$100,000 is not gonna be enough money to be secure the rest of your life either. That's just gonna go in a year or two, right? So if you won the fight and you know your next fight is gonna be double, triple, whatever,
yeah,
then okay, fuck it. I'll tell them, you know, $100,000 is not gonna change your life forever.
That's true.
So buy yourself a car because that's what you want. But in the future, then, you know, invest. You know, buy properties. There's
like right, because it's like you're not secured, right?
You know,
Nevada buy right now property is still affordable. In a year or two, it won't be.
Nevada. Nevada is a lot cheaper than California.
Yeah.
So if you get a couple $100,000 payday,
buy a house, five rooms, and then rent it out,
a lot of people think, oh fuck, if I spend $200,000 in a house and I'm gonna rent the house for $1,000, the fuck is $1,000 gonna do? $1,000 gonna do for me in every month? That's not a lot of money. It's not. But 15, 20 years from now, that rent is going to be worth $3,000 instead of $1,000 per month.
And the house is
going to be worth $500 or $600. That's the difference.
It's true.
That's the difference.
Do you understand what he's saying?
Yeah, of course, yeah.
A five-bedroom house in Vegas right now is like $150. Five-bedroom, brand new.
Mm-hmm.
Here in L.A., you can't get a door for that kind of money. Mm-hmm. It's very expensive.
Yeah.
Try to buy a place right away because... In a few years, there's a big communication center that's going to move into Vegas with thousands of people, and all of them will need homes.
Mm-hmm.
So
you know what I mean. So
what if you don't have what if you don't have enough cash to buy a house, but you put a good down payment?
Then you're still gonna you rent it out. It's a paga sola.
It's a paga sola, right?
So it's the same shit. Say you put up 20%.
Right.
20% of a $200,000 is not even that much money. Fucking what is it? $40,000.
Yeah.
Yeah, $40,000. $40,000, and then you're gonna rent it out for $1,000. Your payment's gonna be like $700, $800.
Yeah.
So you're able to, you know, pay and make a little bit of money for maybe for the gardener, maybe for your property taxes. You know what I mean?
But you think that's a good idea without paying?
Yes, it's a good idea. Yeah. Fuck yeah, it's a good idea.
First time buyer, you could put 5% or 10%.
That $200,000 house in 10 years is gonna be $350,000, $400,000, and then in 20 years it's gonna be $600,000. So yes, it's a good fucking way to do it.
Yes.
Hell yeah.
If you can, buy a few properties. Start with one, but don't go crazy. Don't buy 30. Start with one.
So you pay that one off, and once you pay that one
off. Pay that one off. Next five, once you make to the big paydays, if you could buy two houses in one five, say one day you make $1 million. You got to say, okay, well, I'm going to pay taxes, whatever. You're going to keep $600 for yourself. Easy. $600 for yourself. After you pay taxes and trainer, whatever, you keep $600 for yourself. Fucking spend $400 in homes. Fucking buy two houses.
That's what Mikey set out for 2.5 years.
Yeah.
Without finding a way he could survive. Yeah,
four or five properties.
And he
got them really cheap here in Riverside area because they were cheap 10 years ago.
And he could. How many people could afford to lose their job for 2 years and still be okay?
You own this property?
I own this property. Yeah.
It's good, and he has fighters here and a swimming pool and a gym.
It's not even the house; it's the land, man. It's like. Yeah.
So, there you have it. Another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Elie Seckbach, reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter, @Seckbach. And you can follow me on Instagram, @Elie Seckbach.